Fox News alert, and this is big. The Intercept reported moments ago House and Senate Democrats are planning to unveil new legislation later this week that would officially expand the U.S. Supreme Court by adding 4 new seats that would take it from 9 justices to 13 justices. The effort reportedly being led by House Judiciary Chairman Jerry Nadler and Senator Ed Markey. Joining me now to react to this breaking news is Shannon Bream, anchor of Fox News at Night. Shannon, this is some incredible breaking news. We knew this would probably happen, but we didn't think it would be this quickly. What do you know?
Yeah, we know that there is this commission that President Biden has set up to study all kinds of things with the judiciary about, including expanding courts and with their seats, that kind of thing. But what we're seeing now is actually something being done at the legislative branch. We're in Congress. They're talking about trying to expand the Supreme Court. Now, listen, it hasn't been done since 1869. The Constitution does not outline exactly how many justices there have to be at any one time. The court started with 6, and the theory has always been that the founders thought it wouldn't be used to decide really tough questions on a regular basis. That's why they gave it an even number instead of odd when it got started. But over the years, the seats have been changed many times. So now we're going to see if Congress is serious about that. Democrats control the House. They also have a very slim margin with the vice president's vote over in the Senate as well. So we'll see how serious this is. It's been, as I said, since 1869, since they changed it. When FDR talked about this, about packing the court so he could get his policies upheld and put through, it did not go well for him. I think the American public is going to have a lot of questions. And you heard Justice Breyer just days ago talking about this. When people start to mess with the courts, it starts to look political. The late Justice Ginsburg said 9 is a great number. I don't think we should mess with it. So I think there's going to be a lot of pushback along a number of fronts if they actually move forward with this.
You know, Shannon, it's interesting that Nadler is leading this effort, as there's already been rumors here in New York that he may face some sort of primary. AOC has made it very clear that the moderates in this state, I mean, Engel was already unseated after 20 years in Congress by Bozeman. So how is this going to play out? Is this political pressure? And to follow up on that, the Biden administration made it very clear they wanted to study this. Is it clear now that the progressives are really leading the charge? They don't want to study it. They know where they want to go. Mm-hmm.
Exactly. And there was so much pressure on him, you'll remember, during the campaign from the left and the right, because people wanted to know what President Biden planned to do if he was elected with regard to the seats on the Supreme Court. And you remember he demurred quite a few times, saying, I'll tell you after I'm elected. And a lot of people were saying, well, no, we want to know. But that's because he was definitely feeling the pull from the left side, the left flank, the progressive flank of his party, who wanted him to come out and say, yeah, maybe we're going to do this and add these seats, while the conservatives out there were watching very closely, too, because they don't want the expansion. So we'll see. It's on Capitol Hill now.
Shannon Bream, thank you so much for this breaking news. Mm-hmm.